G'day everybody, welcome to another Affinity Photo tutorial. Thought I would do something a little bit different this week. I'm going to show you how to create this collage effect that I have on screen at the moment. The original tutorial for this is a Photoshop tutorial, and I thought it would be fun to see if we can recreate it in Affinity Photo. I will link the original Photoshop tutorial below, as well as the website Texture Labs, where all of the textures come from. They are also the ones responsible for the original Photoshop tutorial, so that will be linked below as well for you to go and have a look at. But let's see if we can recreate this in Affinity Photo. So let's get started. We're going to start off with the picture of our woman here. Make sure that you're clicked on the picture of the woman, and we're going to come straight up to here to tone mapping. The original Photoshop tutorial uses two filters, one which is oil paint and the other one which is a cutout filter, which we don't have in Affinity. So we're going to try and recreate those. So on our picture here, just going to bring the tone compression all the way down and the local contrast all the way up to get a little bit of texture in there, and I'm going to bring the saturation all the way down, and that is looking pretty good at the moment. So let's just hit apply. So we're just going to smooth out the skin a little bit. So we'll come up to filters, noise and denoise. So on this one we'll bring the luminance all the way up to 100, and on this luminance one here, luminance contribution, if you see we bring it all the way back, then we'll just take it up until we start seeing that skin smooth out about 73 on mine at the moment, so that looks pretty good there. And just hit apply, so we've got that filter applied. The next adjustment that I'm going to add is going to be a posterize on top there, and we want the posterize levels at 4, so just type in 4 and enter. So we've got this look now. So clicking on the background, we'll add a levels, and on the levels we'll just bring the black level up a tiny little bit and this white level down a little bit. And we'll have another play with this a little bit later. Right on top of the posterize, I want to add a live filter, and it's going to be a medium blur. But I want that medium blur just on top. So I'm just going to drag it on top. I'm just going to drag the radius until I see that smoothing out a little bit. About there looks pretty good. And we'll play again with the medium blur a little bit later. The next adjustment, I'm going to add a gradient map. So down here on the gradient map, and on this gradient map, this first level here, this node here, we want to click on that, and the color needs to be black. Going to add another color right in the middle, so just double clicking there, and this color is going to be red. So I'm going to zero the green and add 255 to get pure red. And the position of that, we want it to be 33. On the green, we want that position to be 67%. And then the last one is blue, so that is all good. So we've got our gradient map all sorted. What we're going to do now, right on top of this gradient map, is add some textures. As I said, these textures are all from Texture Labs, and that will be linked below. And again, you can watch the original Photoshop tutorial. That link will also be below. Okay, so the first texture is this texture here. I'm going to copy that over with a Command C and paste it right on top of our gradient map, Command V. Make it a little bit smaller, come over to our Move tool. Just holding my Shift key down, I'm just going to turn that round and then resize it over the top of that picture. And you can move that around a little bit. It's good about there. So on this picture here, the one that we've just put up here, we're going to come over here to Blend Ranges. I'm going to make sure that this little box here says Master. And we're going to change the underlying composition ranges. If you don't know much about blend ranges, Affinity Photo have a really good tutorial on blend ranges, and I'll also link that below for you to have a look at. But for this one, we're just going to come over here to this node here, and we're going to drag it all the way down, just like that, and then we can click off that. The next photo, or the next texture that we're going to bring over, is this colored texture, so Command C. Coming over to our woman right on top of this other one, Command V. Again, we'll use our Shift key, hold our Shift key and turn that around and place it. and drag that all the way down and just place that where you would like to see it, over to blend ranges. But this time we're going to change where it says master to red. We're going to bring this node all the way down here. And I'm just going to bring this node here across a little bit. We'll come back and play with this again a little bit later as well. So we can click off that, and then we'll come to our next texture, which is this one here. So Command C, back over to our picture here, and again, right on top, Command V, reposition it. This time on our blend ranges, we're going to come to the green channel, this little node here, all the way down, and then this one across a tiny bit, and we'll come and play again with that a little bit later. I'm just bringing this one across till I get rid of that. The other one's showing through, so that's okay. And then our last sort of cutout paper texture here is this one, nice and light, Command C, back over to our woman right on top, Command V. Again, we're just going to turn that around, move that into place, back to blend ranges, and this one's going to be the blue channel. Again, on this node, all the way down, and then across a little bit. A little bit, maybe to about there. When, like I said, we'll have another little bit of a play later. So on our medium blur now, we'll come back to our medium blur, and we'll bring that down until we get some more of that detail in. I'm going to set mine about 5 at this stage. And then on our levels, we can have another play with our levels. And this is where it's just totally your choice on how you get it. I'll bring that in a little bit. I'm sort of happy with that about there. I am going to add a curves adjustment on top. And in the middle here, just drag down to darken that up a little bit. And then maybe here a small S curve. So that is looking pretty good. Got two more textures to add. So we're going to add this texture here, the folded paper, Command C. Right on top here, let's turn that around and stretch it out. We're just going to change the blend mode of this one to overlay. And then the last texture for this one is this texture here, Command C. Over to our woman, right on top again, Command V. Turning that one round again. And stretching that out. And again, just changing our blend mode to overlay. Got this really quite arty picture that looks pretty good. There's a few other things that you can do if you want to. Again, play with the levels if you'd like to get that looking a little bit different. You can also come right up the top and add a black and white if you wanted to go black and white, playing with your reds and your yellows just to bring that out a little bit for black and white. We can also add, let's turn off the black and white, you can also add a HSL adjustment, and you can change the color to any color that you would like just by moving the slider around, so you can get sort of a really arty effect. And now once you've got the basic setup here, you can actually add some other things. So I'm just going to come and grab this hand here, Command C, and if I paste this hand just above the background layer here, Command V, make that a bit smaller. Let's turn that around a little bit, place that over the woman, maybe bring it down, and let's drop the opacity to 50%, and then just place that where we can see both eyes. Something like that. You can play around with the opacity, maybe drop it a little bit more or bring it up a little bit. But as you can see, you can get some really nice effects. The other one I might do, if I'll turn that hand off, and I might bring over this one off the tram, Command C, back over. Let's put this one right on top, Command V, and let's turn off the woman's face as well. And let's just put this tram in place now. So as you can see, you can get some really nice effects using this collage effect. You can also go back onto these blend options and just have a little bit of a play just to see what they will do on each of them. Let's go to the red. And as I said, you can have a play with all those little sliders and just see where you end up. But there you go, everybody. That is my tutorial for this week on creating a collage effect. As I said, the original tutorial is a Photoshop tutorial, so go and check that out. The link will be below. And Texture Labs also, that created the tutorial, all the textures on the Texture Labs site you can go and have a look at. If you have enjoyed this tutorial, please give it a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing to my channel. And until next time, I'll say to you, stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in the next video.